So this video will show how to explore the data. So this is the data set. Okay, so we have the absent and present of the genus Pomacea, and also we have excluded the partial present. Okay, the site that we have partial present of the genus have been excluded. So the first thing we need to do is to split the data set according to absent and present of the Pomacea species. And then we're going to split again for each of the absent or present data set into separate habitat, smaller data set. Okay. So we're going to do this in R. So the first thing first is to open R script. Okay. So the first thing is to make sure the directory is the same. So you might want to change this. So after you have done this, then we can read the data set. So the full data set that we have. So we have 20 variables, 479 observation or plots. Okay. So first thing is to split the data set according to absent or present data. So we're going to split this into the site with the Pomacea and also the site without Pomacea. Okay, so the site with the Pomacea is 200, the plot is 226. Okay, so this is a breakdown of the plot for this data set. Okay, and then the site that without Pomacea, so this is number of plot. So this is a breakdown. Okay, so after this have been done, then the next thing is to split it into the different habitat. So for the present data set, so this one we're going to split it into the four smaller data set according to the habitat. We're going to exclude the waterfall. And then for the absent data, we're going to split it into four data set as well. And we're going to write the file. So at the end of the day, we're going to have eight separate file, smaller data set. So you're going to run this. So this only need to be run once. Okay, so after this has been done once, then you will find the smaller data sets occur in a folder. So you will see this in your folder. So this is a smaller data set. So this only need to be done once. So after that, you don't have to do this anymore. So the next time, for the second time, you just need to read the directory and then read all this file again. So altogether, we have 8 files. Okay, so present only data or the site with the according to the habitat. So we have 4 different habitat. So just read the file again. Okay. And after that we can explore the data according to pH. So all the scale have been changed, have been corrected. Okay. All the scale have been corrected. So it's a standardized scale for each of these parameters, so it's comparable. So you can just run and explore a bit. So for example, this is a pH and this is a present locations. So this is a measurement. So you can run one by one. Okay. So you can see it's not much different. So you can explore all the data set. So for example, potassium. So this is a parameter that is significant in the GMM. So you might want to explore this. So you can choose this. So this is all present and this is absent. So you can see the absent usually have a lower potassium concentration compared to the present site. Okay. So you can explore all this. So there's a species, temperature and things like that. So for vegetation and substrate, it's not a scale data. So we only can make a table. Okay. To explore a bit. For example, this is a lakes and ponds. This is a complete absent site, complete present site, and this is number of plot. Okay, and then this is a different vegetation type. Okay, so if this analysis need to be done, need to be plot, we need to use the Mozart plot for the chi-square. Okay, so that's all. So first, split the data. After we split the data, we save the data set. So this only need to be done once. Then after that, whenever we need the data, we just load the directory, working directory, and then read the file again that we have just split, and then just explore the data by according to habitat and also whether the Pomacea is present or absent.